Hello. Hello, everyone. Welcome in. Welcome into the second Alan Wake 2 stream. And I know Jasper won't want to be here for any gameplay, so don't worry, Jasper. We'll be chit-chatting for a little while. How is everybody doing today? There was a Streamlabs update, so I'm fully expecting something to be broken. Call me crazy. Fool me once. For me, 17 times. Mello, congratulations on being first. You were first. You got it right as the clock ticked over to 0001. I love it. Welcome in, Mitch. Good to see you. Abby, hello. Sam, welcome in. Baz, welcome in. Jasper, ToxiFox, welcome in. My headphones weren't on. Yeah, just waiting for that music to end. It was quite nice. I normally wait for the song to finish. If it's a good one, if it's a shit one, it's fine. I'd say I'm at welcome and ready. Good to see you, friend. Okay, Jasper, just to let you know, because obviously you weren't here for yesterday's Alan Wakeness. Yeah, we're doing a raid message competition. If anybody wants to design me the new Platinum Lounge raid message moving forward, whisper it to me. We've got one submission at the moment. I think about two or three people had some good ones yesterday, but only one person officially submitted. This was Minister Gold. So we've got one from Minister Gold. It will be the raid message. I mean, we might get two we really like. We might like mush them together. But I think we'll let the community decide. We're going to try and keep it anonymous as well. So I will just present them in a random order without telling people whose they belong to. How was everybody's day? If I didn't see you yesterday, how was your weekend? But yeah, how was everybody's day? I am feeling quite warm today. Got the heating to a nice level. I'm looking forward to playing some Alan Wake 2 yesterday. We had a little bit of an issue yesterday. It can happen sometimes if you put a game away for a long time. We came back to Alan Wake 2 yesterday. And I think the first hour and a half, we were playing as Saga. And Saga, we've got Saga to the very end of their story. So we had to figure out how to get back across to Alan's story, which Mello did some great reconnaissance, found out how to do that. And so we spent about 3.5 hours, a little bit more, playing Alan's story. But today's going to be completely Alan's story. So I'm very much looking forward to that. It's a weird one. He was involved in a big old song and dance number yesterday. Genuinely. We walked through this kind of stage area and there was like fake woodland everywhere. We were being attacked by the people we frequently get attacked by. But yes, there was a song and dance number, and real like live action Alan Wake was in the song and dance number while we were playing as like gameplay graphic Alan Wake. It was brilliant. It was very good. And I think Abby, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think you said it helped your mood yesterday quite significantly. It was interesting. Your bottle is too small to make gold. That's true. I'm here, pretty good. Day just started, really shaky. Fatigue's a brat. Do you know what it is? I don't know what it is about this time of the year, Jasper. I don't know if you and I, we're not getting the vitamin D we need or something like that, but the fatigue is real. I can barely move. This is a great motivator. You know, it almost makes me want to stream twice a day. And I don't know that there might be a time in the future where I do stream twice a day, two short streams rather than one long stream. But everything in my life will be ready for the stream. I will just move hell and high water to be ready for this. Because I love this. I love talking to you guys every day. I love this interaction we have. But yeah, the fatigue when I don't have anything on is just wild. Absolutely consumes me. Be honest, did you listen to the song after the stream as well, Platy? No, but I feel like I need it to be some kind of command or redeem. I feel like I need it to be. Yeah. Yeah, it was very good. And he was doing this whole like, you know, like when you like slap your foot and then you slap this foot. I feel like I've seen like a Russian kind of dance where they do that. It was truly bizarre, but I think we all had a good time. You started early. I started late, I feel like. I only went live. I normally go live at 46 minutes past the hour. I went live like 48 minutes past the hour today. I started late, I felt like. Maybe I'm wrong, but mine is long COVID. Oh, I'm so sorry, Jasper. I'm so sorry. I don't know what to say. I just hope that you are, you know, living as good a life as you can. And we all appreciate you. We love seeing you here every day. Even when we're playing a game that you don't want to see because of spoilers. I know that you are a big fan favorite in this community. Yeah, we all appreciate you, Jasper. Hello, Intel. How are you doing? Do it. What were you saying? Do it too. Sure did. Then I fell asleep. Alan, what... Oh my, I've got a raid. When did the raid come in? Why did the raid alert not go off? This is, okay. How long has the raid been here for? I'm so, there was no raid alert and I'm scrolling back through chat. Why was there no, I tell you why, it's because Streamlabs did an update and I told you at the beginning there'd be a fuckening. I told you there'd be a fuckening. I have got nothing on any of this that tells me there was a raid until I scrolled down to it. Welcoming raiders. Richie Gamer, can I just say, I was lurking in your chat earlier and I heard the story that you were telling and I just want you to know I appreciate you and it might be quite a tough, you might be going through some tough stuff at the moment, but yeah, I'm always here if you need to talk to me. Yeah, we appreciate you. I'm so sorry, literally nothing has come up about there being a raid, nothing at all. Why is the question? Streamlabs had the update, that's why. Alert box? Yeah, the alert box just did nothing. Did absolutely nothing. Maybe I've got to refresh it or something. Yeah, we're going to have a day of no alerts by the sounds of it. The Thord? 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1. The Thord? Welcome in. Thank you for coming in with a raid. Hello. How are we all doing? You're a fan favorite of mine. The games with spoilers, I threw you on sound only, so I can't see. Jasper's also going to be doing that. Yeah. Two streams a day, potential. Oh, potential. Yeah. I might do. Sending all the hugs and love. Ishmael Minora, hello. Hello, welcome in. How are we doing? I'm so sorry. Are you saying you've been here for 2 minutes? There's not been anything to do with raids on any of my Streamlabs stuff that's happening. Oh, dear. Just a moment ago. Damn it. It's one of those days. Let's go, Sam. What did Sam say? Oh, day 5 of no nicotine. Best day so far. Concentration levels are through the roof. Nice, Sam. Very nice. Jasper says, I'm taking vitamin D supplements. Now need B12, according to the doc. I've been dabbling with the idea of getting B12 injections. They're meant to be pretty good for people like you and I, Jasper. So let me know if you do. Let me know how you get on with them. But I might take them as well. I love you very much. I'm doing okay. I made my peace a bit ago. I don't want to talk about your personal business here, which you gave me, but yeah, I think I was there for the kind of the main part of that conversation, just lurking. I was, you know, eating and doing stuff, but yeah, it can't be easy. And I appreciate you. Just want you to know, I appreciate you. We've got a lot of nice things happening today. Everybody seems to be feeling positive. We've got obviously, some people feeling very fatigued, but that's par for the course of this community. Sam's 5 days without nicotine. That's incredible, Sam. I appreciate all of you. I like that people can open up here and talk about things here as well. It makes me feel very positive to know that people consider this to be a safe space. Volcan, how was your day? Baz, how was your day? Mitch, how was your day? If I haven't asked people yet. My bot wouldn't let... If you give anyone hugs, oh no, he kept trying to give me hugs. The bot told him, are you on Streamlabs as well? I don't know if it's the same. I tried to remember to let you know. Since it sounds like you heard the sadder part, did you also get to hear about that? I didn't. No. I think I was there for the maybe the sadder part, but I hope, I'm glad there is a happy part as well. Chilly here today. It was 3 degrees here earlier. So I might sleep during the stream. We'll see. No worries, Abby. No worries. If I'm a sleep aid to people with fatigue, I'll take that. I'll absolutely take that. If my dulcet tones can be a lullaby to you. Cooking some dinner, no worries, sir. Enjoy your dinner. Gonna head out and get some gummies and some goodies for bath. Oh my goodness, Volcana, some goodies for bath time. How intriguing. Well, I hope you have a lovely bath time. A calm voice, happy to hear it. Whether that is getting your fave snacky, taking a bath, doing art, yes. Doing good, one item away from getting all the trophies for one of the versions of Battle Network 4. The fundraiser I started, that's great to hear. That's great to hear, Mitch, congrats. The fundraiser I started for the month that I didn't get to stream much because, you know, family stuffs. Lovely people helped me meet, then pass the goal for the Epilepsy Foundation. Amazing, look at all these good stories coming out here today. I set 125 to help me get to 140. Nice. Are you being attacked by a cat, Volcana? Is that what's happening? That might be what's happening. Mitch, let me show you something I'm one trophy away from. Before we dive into Alan. I will give everybody an Alan warning, by the way. She's flopping on my keyboard. She has things to say, cat things to do. Right, yeah, super hot. One trophy left. Beat all challenges. Super hot. Super hot. Yeah, we did this one at the weekend. Get the red ending in every level of speedrun, a real-time challenge. So this means it's kind of like this one, which is get red ending in every speedrun challenge. But in this one, when you stop, time stops. But in this one, when you stop, time does not stop. So this was this is the real deal. 0.3% of players have earned this one. And the only challenge I've got left to do is beat the whole game, all 25 levels, in one go without dying. So yeah, that's going to be it. That is what we're doing on Thursday's stream, everybody. So if you want to see me get absolutely ruined on Thursday, yeah, please stop by. Friday, we're playing the new Cursed Walking Dead game. Tomorrow, I'm not sure what we're playing. Tomorrow very much is up for debate. So if anybody has any suggestions. Right, I think we're going to be jumping into Alan Wake now. Alan Wake 2. Their starting positions are scripted, yes. Yes, yes. But if I'm in the way of like a shotgun blast, which, as you know, the bullets kind of spread out like that, then yeah. Lurkies, because I want to play. No worries, Volcana. No worries. Jasper, I need to know that you're hearing me. I need to know that you know that we're about to dive into the world of Alan Wake 2. I think Witchy Gamer. Okay, I've got to do an interview and grab lunch. I'll be back after. No worries, Witchy Gamer. I hear you, and I'm leaving you. I'm so afraid. Get out of here, Jasper. Get out of here. Don't you darken my door again. No, I'm joking. But yes, I would not want you to be spoiled for this. I appreciate you, Jasper. I'm gone. I'm yelling with love. Right, on the second game, I 100%ed the spawn anywhere, and so do you. Okay, cool. Yeah, I'd love to play the VR. I think that's something for the future, I think. I'd love to do that. Okay, I think I've asked everybody how everybody's doing. We all doing okay? I think we're all doing okay. Riddy Crash, how are you doing? I know we've got a couple of other lurkers here. I appreciate you. But yeah, I hope everybody's well. We're about to jump into Alan Wake 2. If anybody doesn't want to get spoiled on the game, I completely understand. Now is the time for you to depart. There we go. All right. Hoping to finish Alan's side of the story today. I think we're at Saga's endgame, but Alan's very much got, I think, two or three chapters left. So let's see how we go. Well, how did we end this yesterday? Yes, I think this is where we discovered that there was a woman who died in the bath here, and Saga fought the woman in the real world. So what are we doing? Exit the hotel, okay. I don't know if I've got many bullets left. Let me just see. Yes, I've got 6 bullets for the revolver. Oh, I've actually got 15. I've got no shotgun shells and no flare gun flares. Right, let's go. What are you working on today, Intel? Was it Titanfall 2? I'm okay, Abby. I'm okay. How are we feeling today? I know you came to the stream yesterday. I think the word you used was grumpy. I can't promise there'll be song and dance numbers today. How are you feeling today? I hope I can still provide you with some entertainment, some positivity. Might not be any singing and dancing. This I cannot promise. I think I might just quickly log into Streamlabs to see if I can get my alerts working. Log in. Yeah, I think this is why, because the Streamlabs website is completely different. They've got like a brand new frontage to the website. I've logged into it now, so hopefully the alerts will work. I should probably log into Triggerfire as well to make sure. Yeah, I've got to log in with that as well. So hopefully if we get any more raids, if we get any more anything, we should get alerts. Yeah, I hate when alerts don't go off. I like to be kind of, you know, ready for people when they pop in. I was grumpy. Okay, today. Snug as a bug in a rug under all these blankies. Perfect. That sounds like a very good place for somebody to be today. It's 3 degrees here. Yellow, hello, Minister Gold. Goldie, you're the only person that submitted to the raid message competition so far. So, yeah, there's currently a 100% chance that on Friday, when we do the competition, you'll win. So, congrats. It might be you. It might be you. How are you, friend? Uncontested. Oh, wait a second. Wait a second. It's Tuesday today. It's Tuesday today. Something might be happening with Mr. Gold. Minister Gold today on Tuesday. How has this particular Tuesday been for you, Goldilocks and the Three Bears? How's it been? Anything to report? I think you had a few butterflies in your basket last night. How's it going? Tell us everything. Right, how the fuck do I get out of here? There should be an exit somewhere, at some place. This feels like the foyer, doesn't it? Aha. I think this is it. I think what we need to do is we need to change the vibe in here from climax to pre-show ritual, I think. Oh, Baz. Have you entered the competition? How exciting. We have a contender. Oh. I don't have any bullets to fight these people, so I'm just gonna have to run. Okay, I couldn't even see what was happening to me. But they had to push back to tomorrow because they don't have a workstation set up for me just yet. Okay. Well, I will check in again tomorrow. Welcome in, Darth. How are you, friend? Good to see you. I've got 15 bullets. And there's a lot of people in here I need to kill. So what I'm going to do is I'm not going to kill any of them. I'm going to sneak out. Sneakily. Are you excited, Gold, for your first day? I stopped caring. Just turn off those emotions. You need to hit that job first day, Gold, like a stone cold killer. They'll be like, everybody hopefully will be like, oh, welcome. Are you excited? And you're just like, I'm not here to make friends, bitch. I'm here to make money. And then Shane McMahon's theme tune from 90s wrestling starts to play. I won't sing it for you. You can listen to it on YouTube. But yeah, Shane McMahon's theme tune starts playing. doing good relaxing tonight. Are you going to be watching any of the football, Darth? Think Newcastle might be playing tonight? Right. There is a... There's half of an echo here. I'm wondering if I should actually... Ow! Don't want to fight you people. I've only got one battery as well. Assumed when the echo was playing, I wouldn't be attacked. I assumed wrong. I'm determined to be cozy today to combat these symptoms. If I force myself to feel good, then I will. Yeah, that's how it works. Yeah. Yeah. So, Abby, what did you do in your free time? How did you kind of relax before you were pregnant? Like, what kind of things did you like to do? You know, just in your free time, in your spare time. How did you unwind? I know you're somebody's more on the anxious side, so maybe you didn't really do much of that. Maybe you just stayed home. But yeah, I'm always curious how people, what they do to unwind. Watch some movies. Might start a Christmas film tonight. Okay. Okay, what Christmas film are we thinking? We thinking Die Hard? What's on the menu? I'm trying to think what somebody like you would watch for Christmas films. Prison Rules Gold, just going to beat up the biggest person there. Yes. Step one is 100% correct. That is how it works. Oh my, there are too many people in here considering how few bullets I've got. All right, I'm just leaving. I'm just going to leave. Hopefully. Is this the way out? Please be the way out. I don't even want to pretend to fight these people. They're too strong. Have I got any heals? I mean, I've got one pot of painkillers. All right, step one, I'll go beat up the boss. Yeah, that's it. That's the way to do it. I recommend Muppets Christmas Carol for giggles. It and White Christmas are the two my husband will actually tolerate. And Die Hard, of course. The best Christmas film ever, Batman Returns. Yes! Yes! Batman Returns is such a good Christmas movie. It's such a good Christmas movie. That like, choral music as well, where they're all singing and there's snow and you get the kind of birth sequence of Penguin. Wild. Great film. Yeah, that is what... I think that and Batman the Animated Series arriving in about 1992 are what made me a Batman fan. Love it. Let me trick myself. I played a lot of games, read books, and crafted. Yes, you... Abby, human contact freaks me out as well. Yay, best friends forever. Best friends forever. Always start with Batman Returns. Yes, do you know what ones I like to watch at Christmas? I don't know why, but Groundhog Day became a Christmas film for me. The Tim Allen Santa Claus films became Christmas films for me. And also, I think it's because I got the trilogy box set for Christmas one year. The Back to the Future films. I don't know why, but they really became... I link those with Christmas. Yeah. Anybody else, what Christmas films do you like to watch? We're not... I mean, depending on what you believe. Welcome back, Mello. Please enjoy your stay. Nick, welcome back also. Nick is like a Walmart greeter for me, and I appreciate it. I need to get Nick one of those little kind of, you know, sleeveless coat things that they wear, the Walmart greeters. Yeah, it would also probably be in blue, so that's... I'd probably get sued for some kind of copyright. But, it would be like platinum lounge blue, though. Okay, so depending on what people believe, November 1st is when you're allowed to... I think as soon as Halloween ends... you're allowed to start doing the Christmas thing. So what is everybody's favorite Christmas film? We won't go with like songs. We'll go with films. If anybody wants to give a good Christmas film, because Darth is going to start their Christmas film watching tonight. So yeah, they might need some recommendations. Home Alone 1 and 2. Nick, you have not just smacked it out of the park. You've smacked it into orbit. Two great shouts. Die Hard, yes, yes, yes. We've had a few Die Hards. The Year Without a Santa Claus, I don't think I've heard of that one. Muppet Christmas Carol. We start with While I Crochet Knives because it makes me happy, yeah. That's as good. I think your husband knows what's up, you know. Polar Express and Elf Last Night. Nice. I really like Elf. It's claymation and it's my ultimate favorite. Really, I'm honest to God, I've not heard of that one. Darth, I hope you're taking notes. This is going to sort you out for the next couple of weeks. Right. I'm so injured. We did what we needed to do, but I am so injured. I can't even tell you.
Zane said the manuscript of Return was the key to escape.
Right, Parliament Square. Which one? Parliament Square. Is it this one? I think it's this one. So we're going to... we're in like... if people watch Stranger Things, we're basically in Alan Wake's version of the Upside Down. And we're going to his real... We're going to where his apartment would be in the normal version of New York. But we're in the Upside Down version of New York currently. Such gorgeous music. I don't think I've seen that one since maybe like the year it came out. Is that the one with Tom Hanks in it? And the kind of weird animation? I seem to remember the animation being a bit weird. Quick save. Nice. Okay. Anything we can take? Oh, this is how we can get back to Saga's reality, though. That's good to know. Mello helped us out with this yesterday. We switch reality using red janitor buckets. But we're going to stay here. Is there any heels in my shoebox? No. Okay. Oh, what's this? This looks like an echo. Echo, 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 echo. Only the red one. We found about 25 gray ones.
Had I chosen to pursue the cult, or had they chosen me for some unknowable purpose? To be a demon. To sort the clues based on my...
Oh, which have you seen it? Heat Miser and Snow Miser. Okay. Okay. Which he knows what's up. Shadows on the wall of the cave. How was your day, Nick? Thanks for popping in. It's still popping up, Nick. I have to say, a lot of chats, it's still popping up about The Incredibles. People are... It's the conversation of Twitch right now. The when, the where, the how. But yeah, how was your day? Are you like making some kind of extension at the moment? Just finished lunch. I something to do like you putting up drywall or something. I hope that project's going well. I'm not entirely sure the ins and outs of it, but yeah, I hope it's going well. They're bound to. I follow someone on TikTok who cosplay. Really, that's cool. Their banter fits so well with the characters. Nice.
Or was I a shadow?
I like stuff like that.
In a performance.
I think I told the story yesterday about on Facebook, like 10 years ago, I read a story about a guy called, like, I think his name was like Tom Best. And he sent a message on Facebook to somebody he did not know called Tom Worst. And about 8 years later, Tom Worst replied. Yeah, so Tom Best and Tom Worst are now friends. The basement, I can only chip away at that some evenings. That's good to do little and often, Nick. I mean, I've got, you know, I couldn't be doing that kind of stuff. I don't have it in me. But yeah, any project that I do, little and often, don't kill yourself doing it. It's the best way to do it. Okay, we just got that echo. Let's run over here. Boop, boop, boop. I really need to heal. Really need to heal. Baz, normally the quiz master. So do you have any Christmas films that you would recommend to us? That's the question I'm asking people tonight. Also, don't forget, if anybody wants to create my new raid message, the pinned message in the chat will tell you more about it. But yeah, I think we've had a couple of submissions. Third for Die Hard. Three people have said Die Hard. I love it. I absolutely love Die Hard. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker. Alan Rickman is so good in that film. Right. This is Parliament Tower. So in the first game, we were actually in this place. We live all the way up there. Oh, we may have been in it in this game as well, actually. Yeah, I think we started in here. Oh, I'm getting kind of Shining vibes. Two missions left for Titanfall, no worries. enjoy. Intel is a big completionist as well. Oh, Baz with Frozen. Baz, I've got good news for you. I think it was confirmed in a Disney shareholders meeting this week that there will be a Frozen 3 and a Frozen 4. Should I load up Cold War? I don't know what that is. Is that a Call of Duty or something? What are we doing? I've not seen the second one, fair enough. But yes, there will be a Frozen 3 and a Frozen 4 and a Toy Story 5. Are they ever going to stop making Toy Story films? I thought 3 was meant to be the last one, but apparently not. Apparently Disney likes to make money. It could be argued they no longer like to make good films, but they still like to make money. The Dark Place. Okay. There's a red light on in here, so this could be the place. Call me crazy. Am I supposed to be engaging with these? I think so. This is quite a sinister location. There's like a dark presence here. They're making one. It's on the to-do list. Yes, I think it was the Disney shareholders meeting this week. They said there will be a Frozen 3, a Frozen 4, and a Toy Story 5. Barry Wheeler. He's our friend from the first game. Just checking in. Tried to call but couldn't reach you. Blah, 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 blah. Shark circling. They now want to turn what happened to AI into a movie. Joined a cult. Alice, you're going to think I've been replaced by an evil double, but I've joined a cult and I love it. Joking about being a cult, kind of. A blessed wellness retreat. Okay. Greetings from Hollywood. Blah, 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 blah. That's probably some lore that I don't feel that I necessarily want or need. For months. Oh, it's Alice.
I didn't leave the apartment. I was flattened by the confusion. Guilt.
That's our wife from the first game.
Fear. I could barely get out of bed. Barry Wheeler started visiting. He even cooked me meals. I couldn't stand the guy when I first met him, but he's a better friend than I gave him credit for. He still checks in. Even after he moved out west.
Okay.
Alice's work had consumed the apartment. Her whole life.
Very quiet in their apartments. I feel like somebody's going to jump out and try and murder me. But in fairness, that's me on a normal Tuesday as well. What am I supposed to be finding? Watch Alice's video. We watched Alice's video. We watched Alice's video. Maybe there's another one.
I needed to get inside the manuscript.
Okay. Right. Well, you're going to give me a clue how to do that. Did Did anybody play a game called Eternal Darkness Sanity's Requiem? But did I watch every second of it? Maybe not. Maybe there was a second chapter. Maybe I needed to watch the director's cuts. With director's commentary. No, it's turned off. I mean, there were more screens that didn't turn on. So, maybe I got to them too quickly. Not quickly enough. Do you know what this is reminding me of, Mello? Step One's a museum. All this artwork on the walls. Oh, hold on a second. Here we go. Yeah, I missed this door. Can you guys hear what she's saying, okay?
One morning, I saw a deer soar past my bedroom window. It was a balloon of some cartoon animal. And I looked out at the street below, and I saw a little girl crying. Like losing that balloon had just ended her whole world. It was the perfect image of the horror of caring. And that's when I got myself out of bed. And I picked up my camera.
So she found motivation to get back to photography because of a little girl's tears.
There was something in the dark. Something I needed to see, to show. The more shadows I photographed and filmed, the more I felt like I was on the verge of a breakthrough. I submerged myself in it. I only went out at night. My search became obsessive, but I still had no idea what I was looking for.
Aha.
There's a world hidden behind ours. A dark tide ebbing and flowing against reality. Faces in the shadows. Fear of the dark is really just fear of what could be, that vast, paralyzing ocean. But photography can freeze reality in a snapshot, put a cage around the infinite and capture it. I need to prove those faces are really there.
Dark Place, The Art of Alice Wake. You never know, Abby, this could be another song and dance number. I don't think it's gonna be, but it's something. When he's in live action, I wonder. The manuscript.
The full manuscript of a novel. Return. A horror story about the dark presence escaping from the dark place, taking over Bright Falls. I couldn't remember writing it. I had not written it. I would never write this. I knew who had.
And you heard.
A monster with my face. If this story came true, Scratch would get out, people would die. Destroying the manuscript, it wouldn't stop it from happening. I would have to fix it, edit it. I could not change the genre of the story. I'd have to work within the constraints set by Scratch. I needed someone in the story to fight the darkness. Saga Anderson. I kept seeing her in my visions. She was already in Bright Falls, already involved, but she was not in Return. Not yet. I'd write her in, try to stop Scratch within the limits of the horror story. It was almost impossible. It was taking too long. I had not reached the end. Before I could finish my edits to the manuscript. The memory of my edits was already fading. Terrible things would happen if the manuscript came true. Scratch was there, at Parliament Tower, undoing my work. He could use the story to escape. He could go after Alice.
Right.
Zane has said we worked on Return together. That was a lie. Scratch wrote Return. I would pay Zane another visit. He had guided me to two murder sites. I needed a new one to get back to Parliament Tower. A new draft of initiation.
Got this glowing hole here where we shot. Don't worry, we're not dead. We're back in the studio again for the third time. Okay, masks. Talk to Mr. Door. I really like these live action sections. As I said yesterday, I've never played a game that's had live action in this way. It's very creative. It's Mr. Door.
Time for this, so let's get it over with. Tell me, was this all fake? A show?
No one said otherwise, Mr. Wake. It was to indulge you, but we can stop pretending now.
Masks come off.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far. I don't even think you know who's under your mask, but you know how to make things difficult for yourself. All these rules, endless, convoluted loops you insist on going through. You are so lucky, you know. There are so many people helping you. Armies of people. Myself. Your wife.
Alice. I need to get to her. She's in danger.
She is. Because of you. And so is someone important to me, someone you pulled into this. You keep opening doors, peeking in, reaching through to get what you want, and that puts you in my path.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have to go now.
Maybe you will make it through this time. This has gone on long enough. This and our Night Springs, it was a nice distraction.
It's time someone gave me a straight answer here.
The next time we meet, the circumstances will be very different.
Uh-oh.
And you would do well to return the favor by playing your part. Or stay out of my way, Mr. Wake.
So we seem to be on the same side. Alan has brought somebody into this that Mr. Door knows.
Whatever you say.
The only person I can think of is Saga, but I don't know.
door, Zane. The masks were finally coming off.
Escape the talk show studio. This is the third time we've had to escape this place. It's a bit... I hope we don't have to come back here again. I want to go someplace else. I'm presuming we're not going that way. Can we go back through the studio? Exit. That's probably a good call. How about this door? That door's locked. Are we going to have to fight people? I would like some more bullets if we're going to have to fight people. Wading through water, considering how reality is kind of changing around us, if we saw like a fin coming towards us, the whole place is like not quite knee high, but calf high. Oh shit.
Hurry, Tom. Not awake. Here is the light at the end of the that held you close, Tom. Go onward, said the granny in the snow. When the panic is biggest, the help is also near.
Thor didn't seem happy to see me this time.
Hearing the master is the root of wisdom. But don't let the game get you down. He's playing his role. Maybe put him in your films, Tom. Like you have put me. Sehän olis.
We're not Tom. My plans for the weekend are the same as always. I will be sat here wishing I was streaming. Yeah, it is Tuesday. Maybe give me 3 days and we'll see if we can figure something out. I don't feel like this is where I'm supposed to go. Let me take a look at the map. You are here. Oh, maybe. Maybe this is right. They keep me sane as well. I need something to keep me sane at the weekend. Oh, here we go. Yeah, this looks right. You all keep me sane by being here with me. End of parts. That was a quickie. Nothing wrong with a quickie, you know? Oh, I got another trophy. They are chucking trophies at me like they're going out of fashion. So that's how we would get back to Saga, but I don't think we want to do that. We probably want a quick save. Is that a shoebox? Yeah. Is there anything else I can grab? I don't think so. Oh, that's a good question. That's a very good question. Oh, boy. My friend got me something quite nice last year, actually. It's difficult to pick best, but it was a fluorescent platinum lounge sign that would sit over here.
Well,
hypothetically.
Well.
And it's in purple. It says the platinum lounge. I've still got it. But unfortunately, we kind of fell out and I never put it up. It was an unnecessary falling out. And I think it was mostly my fault. And I have regrets. I'm not very good at communicating with people. You may have noticed that, you may not have noticed that. But I'm a bad communicator, and I'd like to be a better communicator, because, I'd like to stop falling out with people.
I was chasing the cult through. I ran into the filmmaker, Thomas Zane. An esoteric bohemian with a hard-on for acts of cruelty performed in the name of occult nonsense. A director wants to control every aspect of the world in their films. Is a cult leader any different?
Falling out.
Was Zane just another alias for Scratch?
We fell out.
There was a rumor that Wake and Zane had been working on something together. I was going to get the truth out of Zane with whatever means necessary.
Okay, look for Zane at the hotel. So we're going back to the hotel. I mean, it'd be nice if we could go someplace else, but it's the hotel or the studio or Parliament Square. It would be nice if we could go through the front door this time. I think it's quite cool that they allow you to pick whichever story you want to play at any given time. As you know, we've done a lot of play with Saga. We're now doing a lot of play with Alan. But I feel like this game would have benefited from them telling you, with, like, actually physically bouncing me back and forward between the two stories. I think it would have been nice to have had all this kind of broken up with Saga stuff.
Zane's room.
But we didn't know.
Five was upstairs.
We didn't know. I need more batteries. I cannot fight anybody without batteries. It's very annoying. I've got a decent amount of bullets, but I've got no batteries. I have not found any in ages. Maybe I need to start going through. Oh god. Maybe I need to start going through these rooms. Yeah, because you've got to use your torch on them to burn off their shield, a darkness shield or whatever it's called, and then you can shoot them. But if there are three of them together and I've only got one battery, Baz, what was your favorite gift you ever received at Christmas, or anybody? Oh, we're all the way back. All right, let's go. Let's just power through. Yeah, as you can see, you can't actually see. Let me hide myself. So you can see at the bottom, we've got zero batteries. We've got that whole bar is one, enough to probably burn off a shield of one person. But if we have multiple batteries, we could kill multiple people. Got a decent amount of bullets. Oh, nice. That's a good one. That's a good one, Step One.
Zane would know where to find one.
Getting my first PlayStation. Nice. Yeah, I'm trying to... One of mine would have been potentially getting my Master System for Christmas, but I can't remember if I actually got it for Christmas or if I got it for a birthday. I can't remember, but yeah. I think I got a really nice Power Rangers robot as well at one point.
Inside this messy maze of blood trails, I was chasing the cult through.
Xbox One back in 2013. Nice.
Filmmaker, Thomas Zane, an esoteric bohemian.
Very nice. There are some really good videos of people getting, would be on YouTube, some really good videos of people getting like a NES or a SNES or an Nintendo 64 and absolutely losing their shit at Christmas. I love videos like that. Xbox user in your youth, nice. I played so much NHL on the PlayStation 1. Really? Very cool. Yeah. What was everybody's first console? Step One, I was referencing you a little bit earlier because we were walking through a like a gallery, an art gallery, and it made me think about what you're currently creating. Oh, Jesus, I'm not even in the place yet. Super Nintendo, nice. Nintendo for Melee. The Wii. The Wii was your first console, fair enough. SNES, but the first I played was the NES. I don't know if you can see here. I've got the mini SNES and the mini NES. That's those two there. So I can crack those open anytime I need to. It's not on brand at the moment. I'm owned by Sony. Funded by Sony. But yeah.
Zane's room 665 was upstairs. The elevator.
Had enough of that freaking gumshoe. Dick asking too many freaking questions.
Gonna be attacked by one of these any second. Jesus fucking Christ. I don't have any batteries, I can't kill you. Nice, nice, nice. Okay, we're just gonna run past. It's only on BT TV at the moment, sorry. I think we can find it in our hearts to forgive you, Step One, don't worry. Are there any boxes I can break into in here? Do any of these boxes have any batteries or equipment for me? No. This locker? Yeah, Alan, you've got to get some more batteries, dude. Seriously. Barely got any health as well. Yeah, I've got no pots of health.
To get to Parliament Tower, nothing. I needed to find a murder site. Zane would know where to find one.
Zane at the hotel, okay. I'm just gonna have to power walk through the whole thing. Oh, wait a minute, where are we going? Hotel, where's the hotel? This way. Right, we're not stopping for anybody. We're not fighting anybody. We do not have the stuff to do it, I'm sorry to say. I don't have batteries. I've got the bullets. Down of health. I can't heal currently. Jesus fucking Christ. Are you serious? I can't. I don't know what to do. I don't have the batteries to fight these people. No, because I didn't have the cognitive ability to play games, but I did used to hold the controller in my hands and stare at the screen. Oh, fair enough. Fair enough. Most played game of all time. These questions, Baz, they're so good. My most... I know this isn't what you were asking, but on stream, I think it was Assassin's Creed Valhalla. We got at least 50 streams out of that. Every second of that platinum is on YouTube. That's like 200 hours if you include all the DLCs as well, which I also streamed. Most played game. It could be something like Sonic for the Master System, because at the time, I didn't even think about buying another game. I just played it every day. Got really good at it, played it every day. No other games. So that might be one reason why they put a lot of hours into that. Something like Grand Theft Auto Vice City, because I played it so many times as well. Could be one. Just gonna go down here to see if there's any, if there's been any like respawns of health or anything or bullets. Rise of Kong will slowly climb because Plateau. Baz, can I give you the truth about
Dick
that?
Dick likes to be sneaky when he's going in through the back door.
True. Can I give you the truth about Rise of Kong? I would love to go back and platinum that game, but I genuinely fear that it's been abandoned by the creators because there's no sign of a patch. It is currently, there are aspects of it that are currently broken, but there's nothing. There's no sign of a patch. There's no communication from the devs. There's nothing. What did we get? Oh, we got some health. Oh, we got batteries. Yes. Right. We're in the game, everybody. We're in the game. The game is afoot. Yeah, I'd love to go back. It's not a good game. I won't pretend it is, but it's not the worst game I've ever played. So if I can get... I need to get to a save point, I think. Oh, there's one right here. Don't attack me. Don't attack me. I've got to save. Let me save. I'm in the safe space. Oh, that's absolute bullshit. I'm in the fucking safe space. The light is meant to kill them. You're not meant to be in here. Son of a bitch. Okay. Well, we've saved. We're in... I think we're still in pretty much the shape we were in. Equip. Let's do some healing. We've not got many painkillers, so we can't do much healing. We might as well do both of them. Let's get high as fuck. Let's take all the pills. Actually, yeah. I will save... So we don't have to do any of this ever again. Right. Where is the hotel? Right, we can burn people with our batteries, with our torch. We're in. Wasn't there a safe space here? There was. Okay. We're slowly navigating from safe space to safe space. Yes. Yes, those are all the sounds.
Yes, you, the bastard looking fellow. You've just been Captain Quirklington.
Now, that is a real deep cut. That's... There's a lot of plat lore that some people might not know about. So that's a deep, deep throwback to... to bygone times. So, yeah. Yeah.
There are so many holes in this game, Kay, and I've been in all of them.
Yeah, that is true. Can confirm. Let's switch you from Climax. Oh, baby. I was watching you two smash last night. I love that you both picked Smash at the same time.
Myself.
I'd say I have substantial plat. Sam, respectfully, there is so much lore. There is so much lore that you don't know about. You've got, I would say you are... I'd say you're kind of beginner level. You're getting there, but you're still pretty beginner level. Yeah, I did it as sights and sounds.
Maggots.
Garth Marenghi's Dark Place. Test you. Who is the K from the holes command? Oh, fuck. Jesus Christ. Ow. Damn it. Jenga's been bamboozled, yes. Who was my first ever follower? Shush. Jenga, yes, you've been bamboozled. Right, at least we're in the building now, so we don't have to go all the way back. We don't have to re-get the batteries. intermediate level platform. Sam, respectfully, when did you joined for... you joined in the year 2023. I've been streaming since 2021. So, yeah, there's so much plat lore that's come and gone. But, yeah, you'll get there. You'll get there. 3 months, yeah. Out of 2.5 years. Yeah, that's a decent amount. You're on the board. First ever, yeah, my first ever follower. Don't think anybody here knows that. It's so quick. Ow. Baz, I appreciate that. I would have...
Hails! Hails!
This is a good one.
Hails!
Join him, boy.
Hails!
Join him, boy.
Hails.
Yeah, it's a good one, isn't it?
Hails.
Hails up inside ya! Finding an entrance where they can.
Mighty Boosh. I appreciate that, Baz. I would have found you sooner. I would have whispered to you sooner if I've known about you. I don't know. I appreciate you. Right. I think what I'll do, maybe I'm making this too difficult for myself. I need to change the story. Because we're in the climax.
I needed a new draft of the story.
Oh, I can't change it. Okay. Because, yeah, we're in, as you can see, we're in entrance or climax. But I can't seem... You can change it to a few different things. One was haunted, one was the devil. I think this might be one of the more difficult versions of the story. Let's go this way. Oh, that's... Oh. The way out. Yeah, that's the exit. I'm just finding any doors I can that don't get me killed at the moment. How can I kill the people if they run off? You're dead. You're dead. I can hear somebody appearing behind me. Oh, let's keep moving. Just keep moving. Oh my god, I'm down to 3 bullets already. Right, where would Zane be? Look for Zane at the hotel. Was Zane upstairs? Can I change my board yet? No. My plot board is empty again. Damn it. Let's go. Realistically, if I got an early plat lore correct, it would be. It would have been insane. It would have been very, very weird. Okay. I'm just going to keep walking around the place. Is this new or is this old? I think we've been... This is the murder site, isn't it? Yeah. This is the murder site. So I think Zane might be upstairs, potentially. Let's go back. One thing I will say about this game is I'm frequently lost. Might be a me thing. I'm happy to wear it if it is. But I'm frequently lost. I think there's a difference between not holding your hand and... I've got to change this. I can't change anything. Not holding your hand and just like literally throwing you. You know those parents that teach a child to swim by just like chucking the kid in the pool? That's what I feel like is happening. I'm just always lost. So how do I get upstairs then? How do I get upstairs? I think we were talking about it a little bit yesterday. This game feels, not in a bad way, but it feels like it's very much taken lead from recent Resident Evil games. The fact that the enemies are bullet sponges. Intel. For Titanfall. Oh. Dude. You just need to become a console gamer. That's it, Intel. You need to give up that PC. I'm so sorry. Is this for Titanfall, right? Or is this all your files? I think I'm fucking lost now. So yeah, they've obviously completely dived into what Resident Evil's doing, and it works by and large. I just wish they hadn't been quite so faithful. So I feel like the lifts were there yesterday, but we're in the wrong scene at the moment, so it doesn't matter. What about in here? Is anybody in here? No. This one was back to the ballroom, wasn't it? Oh, yeah, murder site. It's not called the ballroom anymore. It's called murder site. Zane's room. How do I get there? Back, right, left. Hopefully. Back. Yeah, I think he's upstairs. Container. Ooh, hello. Didn't see you there. Some heals and some... Is that bullets? Yes, it is. Titanfall. Sorry. I don't know what to say. I'm genuinely sorry. I have to say nicotine free has helped with my... Really? Good to hear it. I mean, Jenko, obviously, you know, giving up any addiction is tough. I can't really say I've ever had to do it myself. But if there's anything that tells you you're on the right track, it's this, what you've just said, and the fact that you are, your brain fog is going. Like, you know, the only person that can stop you doing what you're currently doing is you. The only person that can get in your way is you. Yeah, just keep pushing. You're doing great.
Something told me Zane wouldn't be happy to see me this time.
A different game. Do you think it's the game? Oh, we're getting a raid. I saw the raid this time, even though there are no raid messages. All our alerts are broken. The alerts are broken. Welcome in, Mayhem Magpie. Welcome in, Chaotic B. How are you today? Thank you so much for the raid. I don't know why the alerts aren't working. Slob's had an update. Slob's had an update today. And so now my alerts aren't working, obviously. But yes, hello. Welcome in. How are you? What were you playing today? Welcome in, Mayhem Magpie. Not too bad. We're playing Alan Wake 2. So if anybody that's coming in the raid does not want to be spoiled on Alan Wake 2, yes, I will let you know when we're going back in. I'll keep it paused for a little while. Very good game. I'm frequently lost and the bosses are bullet sponges. But other than that, I'm having a very good time. Was doing some Minecraft, just random stuff. Nothing too crazy. Minecraft sounds quite relaxing. I've seen some people play it recently. It seems quite relaxing. I know you can be attacked by things as well, but I have that obsessive compulsive disorder where if I started building something, I would just get absolutely, it would consume me. And I just build and build and build and build and build. So yeah, it seems nice. I think it'd be quite therapeutic for me just to let my OCD, the way I manage my OCD is I let it run riot sometimes. And then I don't. So it's like this two sides of me. So I know that when I'm done letting it run riot, it will behave. It will just sit in its little box. But then I will unleash it. I think the OCD is like where I do my platinum collecting, my trophy hunting. I just let the OCD go absolutely buck wild. And then I can do my normal life without the OCD. It's a good kind of trade-off that I've worked out that, yeah, that kind of, yeah, it's good. Very relaxing. I do get absorbed into builds all the time. Nice, nice, nice. Ishmael Menora, Warhammer miniature games in general. Is that to me or is that to Chaotic B? Because I do not partake in any Warhammer miniature games, but I used to do some painting back when I was quite young, actually. I used to go down to Games Workshop. I used to buy some Warhammer. I never played the games, but I enjoyed painting them with my dad. So that was nice. But yes, no miniatures for me. I do watch people on Twitch who paint miniatures. That's as close as I can get to that these days. Yes, I could recommend somebody to you if you'd like to. If anybody wants to know a Warhammer painter stream, I'd be very happy to give you that, to recommend somebody. Where's my keyboard? Where is my keyboard? Oh, it's here. Yeah. Lovely people over there. They do Warhammer painting streams. Very knowledgeable. I think they play the game too. So if anybody was interested, it's very therapeutic, very relaxing. Yeah, they actually, I think they own a Warhammer shop. So that's how they get all the kind of the kits. They do giveaways, things like that. So yes, very nice people. Much more into the lore and gaming. Fair enough, fair enough. Ishmael, tell me something more about you. Have you been here before? I don't know. The name seems familiar. I know you came in with a raid, right? But yeah, tell me something about you. I may have forgotten, but yeah, whereabouts are you from? What kind of games do you like to play? A few times. I think I remember the name, yeah. I think you come in with that crew. Canada. Interesting, because we have had such an influx of Canadians over the past month or so. Can I ask what, is it province or what's the word? It's not state, because everybody seems to be from, I think it was Ottawa. Everybody here is from Ottawa. Real-time strategy RPGs. Province. Ontario. Was it Ontario? Or was it, it might have been on, I'm going to need to check, it might have been Ontario that everybody was from. I think it was Ontario. Is Volcana here? No. Jasper isn't here either. Zaya isn't here. Yeah, they're all from the same, Ottawa is a city. Sorry, it'll be Ontario though. They're all from Ontario. Yes, they're all from Ontario. So it's, we've got another person from Ontario. That's so wild. Gonna raid and lurk, got things to do. B, I really appreciate you coming in. I'll hopefully catch up with you really soon, but yes, we're going to be here for at least probably another 3 hours, so do what you got to do. But thank you, friend. Let me just give you some shout outs. Actually, too busy chatting away, let me give you some shout outs. It's _, isn't it, like Miss Mello? Yes, I remembered, my brain did something. There we go. Yes, make sure to follow B. If you like Minecraft, other things too. But so they got some Minecraft going on at the moment. There we go. At least the clips are working. The alerts are not, but the clips are. Ontario has a good portion of the population. Fair enough. Fair enough. Well, if any of the other ones stop in, any of my other Ontario crew stop in, I'll make sure to introduce you. Not that you all need to know each other, but yeah. We found out yesterday we've got two Latvians in the community, and I need them to be in the same stream so I can introduce them. But yes. Anyway, Ishmael, you're very welcome here. Always welcome here. Right, we're going back in. Oh, really? Oh, okay. Fair enough. Fair enough. Community meet and greet. Yes, I have to pop over.
I'm in control now. The second you try anything, I will shoot you in the head. Scratch wrote return, not me. You're a fucking liar.
You'd given up. You stopped writing. You said it was too dangerous, that we didn't deserve to get out. And then he showed up. He promised to write. To get me the hell out of here. was magnificent. A visionary. I mean,
I'm hoping he's being sarcastic, Mello, but yes, they are. They like to dabble in some live action.
When it finished, it took return and left me behind. It's still here, and so is he.
You never know.
I fucked up.
You never know.
But you can still catch him before he gets out, before he gets to your wife. When you get to him, don't hesitate. Kill the bastard for what he did to us. There's a murder site in my cinema where my film Nightless Night is playing.
Nightless Night. Brody, there's a lot about this game I love. Not too much that I dislike, but yes, I'm not surprised it's been nominated for Game of the Year because I've not played anything with this kind of narrative structure before. Like, I'm sorry, like bouncing back and forth between live action or some of the echoes, what they do with the echoes. Quantum Break. Yes, and I think Quantum Break had... what's his name from... Man of Medan. I forget. I can't remember the actor's name, but the character was called not Cody, something like that. Yeah, and he was in both of them, and he's in this as well. So yeah, he's been in two live action games. Right, Zane's film in Initiation 8.
I had to find the movie theater Poet Cinema.
Where is the movie? So is the movie theater in this building? Or is it out?
Film in tandem with Return to escape the dark.
Yeah, I'm presuming there isn't a theater in the hotel. There could have been, but I think we've got to leave probably. Yeah, so let's get back in the lift. Did you see that? That was so weird. Sean Ashmore, yes, but I didn't even mean it. Comrade, I meant Comrade, yes. But they are one and the same. I saw my friend Sale play Quantum, is it Quantum Break? Yes. I saw him play Quantum Break and Conrad was in it. And so yeah, that game has appealed to me for a little while actually. Right, let me call you. Are you at work? You at work, Mello? You at work today? I mean, at work, but, you know, like, working from home at work. Hale, new menu is ready for Friday. Three Fat Cooks, pitch it. Pitch it to me right now. We're all like, this is like Dragon's Den crossed with like a restaurant. You need to tell me what your menu is and we will decide whether we're going to hire you as our chef. I'm excited. How are you, friend? I hope you're doing really well. Yeah, Three Fat Cooks, this Friday, UK time, I think 1:30, we'll be cooking. We'll be cooking up a storm. I mean, if you're in America, we're talking like 8 a.m., I think. 8:30 a.m. So if you want to get up for it, by all means. But yeah, if you're in the if you're European, it's probably going to be a very good time for you. Let's hear this menu. Very excited. Swing out here at the same time. Run. Do you know what, Sam? You could do me a favor if you want to. If you go on PSN profiles, we may have gone past the 60% mark, so I can now look at the trophy list. So you may be able to chuck me up a follow spotlights in the sky. Oh. Spotlights in the sky. Is that what it said? Spotlights in the sky. Oh, these. I see. Yeah, I see. Yeah, so if there's anything there, Sam, that you think is accomplishable in this stream, probably something to do with killing people in a certain way, serve it up to me. But check, we've gone past 60%. We've got two trophies and we were quite close. Right, Italian menu, spaghetti bolognese and garlic bread and a tiramisu. Oh, that sounds divine. You're going to eat well at the weekend. You're going to eat well at the weekend. 61%. Nice. Yeah, something about maybe killing people in a certain way. Nothing to do with collectibles, because I'm not going to be collectible hunting today. But something like that, yeah. So in case people don't know, I wait till I get to 60% of the trophy list, and that's when I first will look at the trophy list, because I used to immediately look at the trophy list, and I hated it. It made me play the games in such a weird way. Where I was trying to get the trophies as quickly as possible, and it ruined the stories and games for me. Are we going the right way? I felt like the spotlights were... Oh, God. I felt like the spotlights were over here. I probably should have healed up before I did this. But it is me, so I don't tend to do things the right way. Right, we'll stop in at the little coffee room on the way. And heal up. Tappy, tappy, tap, tap. Right, let's go. Zane's film. In a world.
I had to find the movie theater Poet Cinema. The next murder site was there. Zane had created the film in tandem with Return to escape the dark place.
Where's the lift? Fully upgrade a weapon, defeat enemy with an explosion. Yeah, I think the explosion one could work well. I think maybe that might be a saga thing, because I do have a propane tank or something. Fully upgrading a weapon is down to me finding cultist stashes, and the stashes have fragments of manuscript pages, and you have to put those manuscript pages together to do one upgrade. It's a very weird system, but you cannot, they're not plentiful at all. Right, so instead of dying again, we'll save here. Okay. So at least if we die, we'll appear back there. See, this kind of style of anything, I've never seen this in gaming before. This is an echo. We're playing a previous conversation. And they look fantastic. Big fan. I'm in no mood.
I could see the searchlight beams, the room with the
searchlight beams. Oh my God, I can hear them. Right, we're going to save here as well. So if we die, this is where we'll respawn. Perfect. Right, so where were the spotlights? God, don't get trapped on the scenery. This is not the time. Bracelet spot. I don't even know if I've got... I don't remember getting a bracelet. For these spotlights, which I've lost, obviously. Fuck's sake. Yeah, I can't even see where the spotlights are. It would probably be better if we did die now. so I can respawn with all my bullets and my life again. Where are we going? Follow the spotlights in the sky. Which spotlights? Can't see the spotlights. I think I'm just gonna let somebody kill me. I think I've got one charm. Yeah, I don't know where or how I got it. I think Saga's got it actually. On her person. Where the fuck are the spotlights?
Wake.
Piss off. Probably two streams. Okay, where are the spotlights? Where is the theater? Poet's Cinema, is this the place? I can't put a marker down there, how brilliant. Right, back and then turn right down Draft Street. I think this is right. What am I supposed to do? I'm shining the torch right in his eyeballs. And he just walks through it and punches me in the face. What am I supposed to fucking do? In the first game, you could get different levels of torch. Like, you could pick up... You had your small torch, bigger torch, then, like, a massive torch. Maybe there's, like, a better torch somewhere in this game. I could not tell you where it is. I've never found a better torch. Right, where are we going? Forward, turn down Draft Street. I'm assuming this is the place, Poet Cinema. I feel like this is the place. Hold on a minute, is that a word of power? Oh, that's an echo. I'm not sure if I'm meant to have, like, different... Yeah, I've only got any shotgun ammo. If I had, like, 50 flare gun ammo, we'd be fine. Dredge this weekend, nice. Fuck's sake, I don't even know if I killed him. Gave him four bullets and then just disappeared. Maybe I'm supposed to have like flashbang grenades or something. I don't know. I do not know. I don't think there's any point in fighting them. I think I just got to run past them. I feel like it's quite underleveled, but I couldn't tell you how this has happened. I've got a shotgun. I've not seen shotgun ammo in God knows how long.
The shadowy gone.
Oh, for fuck's sake, I can't even pause in peace. Stand under this light for a bit of safety. Okay, right, so we take the next right. Down to Poet Sim. I think this is the right place. I cannot see any lights in the sky. Don't stop running, Alan. Eyes down. This is a rough neighborhood. Just keep going. The shadow moved too fast to see. It moved too fast to do a lot of things, Alan. Like shoot it, like shine a torch at it, like anything of any use. Oh, fuck off. Can I climb this? Alan, please climb something. Oh, okay. We can just walk around it. That's fine. Ah. What am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? I've got no fucking... My guns are too weak. I've got like 10 bullets. We've gone through about 20 people. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I've got no flares. I've got no flashbang grenades, which are good for groups. I got nothing. I got absolutely nothing. One flare, I think. Have I got one flare? Let's use our one flare. See how far that gets us. Had it gone? I can still hear stuff, Alan. Don't feel like it's gone. Yeah, I can definitely hear something. Did I just miss it? I think I just missed it. It's too quick for me. This would have been a great time to have the flare. Where am I even supposed to be going? This is where we came from, yeah. Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. Yeah, I think one of the things that this takes its lead from Resident Evil is the idea that you have like no ammo at all. Yeah, walk on eggshells, ammo scarcity. I have 17 bullets. Sorry, I have 13 bullets. I've got my torches. I've got my batteries. Should we do a run where we actually used all the torches and all the batteries and all the bullets? and see how far it gets us, because I don't think it's going to get us that far. Dude's got some kind of blade. Alright, we're down to 4 bullets. We are no closer to our target.
There's no escape. These are my words. You can't stop the story.
I'd love it if he could load a gun quicker. Right, we've used all our bullets for our gun. We've used our one flare. And look at these three, just waiting for us. Like, what ammo am I supposed to have? What stash of bullets was I supposed to find? Sam, do you want to read back that message you just sent me? Is this even the right way? The mission says follow the spotlights in the sky. I've not seen any spotlights at all. Spotlights in the sky. I don't see any.
The story determined where I could go.
Okay, so we're not going that way. Let's try this way. Hope the Alan Wake is still funny. Yeah, it's... I've got no ammo. I'm just fighting scores of people with no ammo. It's very difficult. No worries. No worries at all. How have you been today? How was your day? Oh my God, I'm being attacked from every angle. Get the fuck away from me. I've got nothing I can do. Yeah, how's everything with you? How was Silent Hill? Yeah, I'm playing something equally spoopy today. But it's spoopy how little ammo I have. That's the real trauma. Can't say I'm enjoying Silent Hill 1 as much as I'd like to. Yeah, this is getting to a bit of an issue now. I've got no ammo with Saga Anderson. I've got no ammo with Alan Wake. So I'm up against two brick walls. It's not fantastic. Need to find a nice stash of ammo someplace, but we found exactly nothing. See you in a bit, mate. Have a good one. I think he's playing Uncharted 3, which I did enjoy. I think it's my... I mean, I enjoyed them all, but I think of the four, it's probably my least favourite because of the villain. Georgie, how are you doing, friend? Don't want to get spoiled on this one. Georgie, I'll pop a pause. I hope your weekend was good. Completely understand. I think we've got about four people that are doing the exact same as you, popping a lurk and getting the F out. Yeah. So I think my favourite is two. It's difficult to pick between one and four. Four obviously has the graphics. One is that great kind of intro story where we're getting to learn about everybody. But I think three is my least favourite, yeah. Savvy Sam, how are you, friend? Good to see you. How was your weekend? How's streaming going? Hope you're having a lovely day. I suppose it's very late for you, so I hope you had a lovely day. Yeah, Georgie, I will... Nice. I really have high expectations on this one. Yes. Very good. One thing we're kind of struggling with at the moment is that I've got no bullets. I've got no ammo. I've got nothing to heal myself. It's done. It does that Resident Evil thing where you've got to manage your ammo, and it's just not something I've any interest in gaming, really. I find it very boring. So we're kind of a bit fucked at the moment. We're going up against the same people over and over and over again, trying to just weave through them because I've got very limited ammo. But yeah, it is what it is. Haven't played one and two. Plan on the first. Love three and four. Yeah, three is comfortably my least favorite. It's still a very good game, but two is the best of all of them. I really want them to do a full remake of two. Yeah, it's superb. Survival horror things, you know. Yeah. Yeah, no, it's not my genre, I keep telling people. I really enjoyed Alan Wake 1, so I thought I'd play Alan Wake 2 as well, but it's just not my genre. Before leaving, all good, your weekend? Yeah, very good, very good. Lots of good things happening. Yes, we will be playing Super Hot on Thursday, going for a platinum trophy, and then Friday is The Walking Dead. We're playing The Walking Dead Destinies, which is in contention for worst game of the year. So, yeah, look, we're looking forward to Thursday and Friday. Tomorrow, I'm not sure, actually. I'm not sure what the plan is for tomorrow. 3 a.m., just woke up. That's one way to do it, Savvy. That's one way to do it. Really hoping Silent Hill 2 with a jump from PS1 to PS2 is more enjoyable. I imagine there are a lot more mechanics, yeah. I'll be there to watch them. Enjoy the game. Thank you, Georgie. Yeah, we'll jump back into it. We'll jump back into it now. So I think this is the bit we always get to. And then we get absolutely ruined by people from all angles. So I need to burn my way through you. But then I get attacked by somebody. Is it you? Can we walk through this? No, then what the fuck do we do? What do we do? This feels like where we're supposed to be. Yeah, I mean, it's a bit of a departure for me because I really enjoyed the first one, but I'm finding that the survival aspect is the bit I'm struggling with. I'm not struggling with the horror whatsoever. It's the having to really take care of your ammo. That's very problematic. I feel like I'm missing like weapon stashes. I'm missing, you know, packs of bullets, health. But maybe I'm not. Maybe this is how the game is. It's just, you know, has tank controls. And where he's facing up on left stick makes him walk. It is rough. Sounds rough. Doesn't sound nice at all. Right, let me check the map. Is this the right place? Car wash. No, so I think we need to go a little bit further down to the Poets Cinema. But how do we get there? How do we get there? Okay. Don't think the game wants us to go in there. Go to Poets Cinema. Yeah, for the spotlights in the sky. How the fuck am I supposed to get there? I think this is Poets Cinema over here. Yeah, you can see it. It says the word Poets down the side. Am I supposed to be able to climb something here? Oh, it's a fucking door. Oh, it's locked.
Opened on the side.
Yeah, this will be like a shortcut. A shortcut back. There were more bits to burn, that's what it was.
Light cut through the darkness.
Right, now what we desperately need is a place to save. No, get the people in the foreground. Shit, shit, shit. I don't want to die again. This is more progress than we've made in a while. No, why are you locked? I thought it might be a safe spot for me. Right. I can hear you moving about back there. I've got a ticket. Please enjoy the film, sir. Game saved. Okay, good. Good, good, good. I still want to find a place to
the cinema lobby. Final casing. To other realities on the silver screen. I could set a scene here.
I still need to find a place to save. Aha. Normally when you see lights, that means we've got a little coffee room. Yes. Quick save, right. Even if we die, we're still in this room. Still in this building, I should say. Perfect. No more carving through those enemies outside. Okay. Anything good here? And by good, I mean any ammo, any health packs, anything. Lots of pizza.
Did I stop writing at some point? I can't stop. There's too much at stake.
Okay, at least we've got some ammo. Map. Yes, please. Poets Cinema map. Good. Yeah, Nom, it's going to be wild. Friday, be there or be square. We're going to do a let's play, but we're going to do a review at the same time, which is something I like to do when I play these quote unquote not great games. We'll call it a not great game. We'll try and be nice. She's playing it as well, but still going to watch you play it first. Pretty sure you're playing it first anyway. Yeah, it's going to be... I think it comes out on Friday, so I think a lot of people are going to jump on Friday. I mean, it comes out in physical form. It's been out on digital for a while. So if digital is something that Linny likes to play, she could actually play it sooner. But I'm going to get it on physical in case I guess I need to send it back, Nom. You know, just on the off chance... then I might decide that I need to send it back. Let's go in here. Let's save again. We found some stuff and things, so we'll save again. Okay, right. We did get a map. I don't exactly know. The murder.
I had to find my way to it.
Yeah, okay. So where's the map? So we are here. Do we want to go to the projection room? Is that the plan? Linnea's never played a bad game on stream before. Nice. And she's a PC gamer, so she'll have to keep it. Unless Steam lets her refund. Yeah, I think it's a time thing, Steam. I think it's a time thing. So she needs to read up on that very carefully. Unless she loves it. You never know, Norm. She might absolutely love the game and might decide that she wants to play it forever. And ever. And ever. And ever. And ever. And ever. Murder Casey. Under 2 hours, guaranteed refund, but you can still refund if you have more than... well, yeah. I think... Call me crazy... But she might have a good reason.
I felt like I'd been on this case looking for the cult of the word for a lifetime or more. The only case I'd ever been on. They would surface from the dark with their depraved acts of violence and fade back into the night, leaving behind bloody crime scenes and clues heavy with obscure meanings that led nowhere. Arriving at the cinema, I felt a monumental, terrifying revelation trembling before me, ready to open its jaws and swallow me whole.
This place had significance to the cult.
Okay.
There was something to use there.
Right, so we've got a plot point, or whatever you call them. So yeah, it's quite cool. Yeah, so I think Remedy made Max Payne.
I was missing something.
And Remedy makes Alan Wake. And I think Sam Lake is the voice actor. I think Sam Lake is the creative director for both franchises. But he's also in both franchises. He plays Alex Casey in this. So yeah, he's known. He's about... Oh, we got a flare and we got some health. Perfect. Right, let's go. So yeah, if in case people haven't seen this, it's quite a cool plot device. Isn't the voice of Max? Oh, I think he's the look of Max rather than the voice of Max. I think he in some of the character shots, it's Sam Lake, I think. Yeah, the face. That's yeah. That's, I was getting myself confused. Yeah, right. So in case people haven't seen this, it's quite fun. We can change the story. And we can now see it through the eyes of the cult of the word.
I had to be at the scene to see and understand it in order to change it.
I must have just crept out of the area. There we go. Lobby, cult of the word. And so the whole location will change.
The first
which is quite
step
fun.
Toward the murder site, I was making progress. Someone had barricaded themselves in the room.
Yeah, so we should get a few more of those as well. So we can make multiple locations change in multiple ways. Do a quick save. Anything worth finding? No, we've probably got to go back upstairs, I think. So somebody had barricaded themselves in a room, he said. Cult of the word. Probably not this room. Ooh, hello. Hello, hello. What's this? That's a grenade. That's another flare. Can't take this health pack though.
Okay, nice and healed up. So how many spaces does that health pack take up? Perfect, there we go. A little bit of itinerary management. Sorry, inventory management. This way. So somebody's barricaded themselves in a room. I'm gonna guess it might be upstairs. Nope, these rooms are still blocked off. What's the thing? Locate the murder site, yeah. Yeah. Unless it was this room. No, that room's still locked. So I'm guessing that room's not going to be locked through one of the ways we change the plot. We haven't got it yet, though. What we need. Is it back here? How do we get back there? Looks like the right place. Okay. Oh, have I got to... I bet you... Yeah, I think I know what to do. So I've got to change back into the previous way we saw it. And then when we get inside that room, change back. How do I... So can I not change out of the cult of the word? Yeah, that's it. So yeah, if we change out of the cult of the word, then if we go into this room here, and then we change back to the cult of the word, it should move around us again, I think. It should change. But this time we're not locked out, we're locked in. But that's kind of what we want. There we go. Oh, right, cult of the word. So yeah, we're barricaded in now, but that's good. So, what are we looking for? Let's look at this echo.
I do you a lot of good to talk, buddy.
Buddy.
It was an initiation ceremony. Or so we made our new members believe. Two of New York's finest. They had performed endless favors to earn their place among us. We had something special waiting for them. And something very special for you, Alex Casey.
Who's your leader? Alan Wake? Scratch? Zane? Give me a name!
You will meet him soon enough.
There was... Good day, sir! I said good day, sir!
Good day, sir. That sounds lovely, Abby. Have a good one. Right, so we've got a new plot element, New York's finest. So I don't think we can use it now because we're locked in. I mean, we might be able to. We'll try it first. We might still be locked in there. It's looking a lot cleaner, a lot less bloody as well. So it sounds like somebody on the in the police was on the payroll. Made it on the payroll, but was in with the cult. Okay, we're back outside. I will save. So, locate the murder site. Investigate the theater hall. Where's the theater hall? Map. Screen. Big yellow arrows normally mean collectibles. Okay. That door is still locked. It'll be open eventually for one of the scenes. Okay. Don't think I can go through these yet. I think this was the way in, wasn't it? Yeah. So where are we going? That's where we just... Oh, did we come from this way? Yeah, nothing here has changed.
Writing was affecting reality.
Let's get the theater hall. Right, where is the theater hall? That's where we are now. Concession stand. Screen. Projector room. Editing room. Maintenance rooms. I don't know. Let's try New York's finest. Oh, there we go. It was here looking me in the face the whole time. Right, theater hall, new scene. This reminds me so much of my local cinema. I think it's closed down now because of COVID, but yeah, very similar. So quick. Right, theatre hall. Was there anything here I needed to find? Was this a box I can... Yeah, let me see what's in here. Cool, I got my bullets back from that guy. Oh, another box. Health pack. Oh, I can actually heal. So I can take you after all. Perfect. Right, theatre plot board. Should we try looking with Cult of the Word? Here we go.
Alan Wake.
Oh, it's just going to loop. Well, that's helpful. Oh, there's an echo. How do I get up to you?
Created one film, Tom the Poet,
missing, mirroring the vanishing of the main character in the movie, played by himself. The biggest mystery was around his lost film, an early work made in Finland, Nightless Night, rumored to have mystic properties.
This dude's getting close to me.
It was a snuff film, that the ritual murder in the film was an actual murder. There were no known surviving copies.
I hope I don't have to fight all these people.
It as if it were their unholy grail, just like Wake's books were.
Alright.
Wake.
So we did Cult. Let's try New York's Finest.
Alan Wake. The scene here had changed.
So I think this is where they did some of their ritualistic stuff. Got up to some of their ritualistic shenanigans in this place.
Alan Wake.
Am I supposed to do something over there, though?
Wake.
Am I supposed to take a seat? Of the word.
Alan Wake.
Please don't attack me. I'm in no mood.
Wake.
What else have I got? I think we did everything with this one. Unless I've got to change. Ah, an echo is appearing.
You, following your master into La La Land. A sad bunch of clowns in funny masks and hoods, pretending to be a secret society. Maybe it is you who's playing a role, Mr. Casey. A role carefully laid out for you. A puppet, blindly performing the ritual steps for the glory of the cult. Huh? What the fuck have you been smoking? Nightless Night. A clip of the lost film survived. You will see, Mr. Casey. In the Nightless Night, you will finally see.
Nightless clip of the lost film.
It played a role in this story.
Okay. Oh, please, Alan, for the love of God, reload your weapon. Oh, reload, Alan. Be quick. No. Very good at the combat in this game. It's better than the first game, but it's not that enjoyable, I have to be honest. Not that enjoyable. I presume there are power words like littered through the game, and I think I've done a few upgrades, but I just, yeah, I'm a million miles away from being as strong as I need to be to fight some of these people. So yeah, it was this way. Have I still got all of the plot points? Or am I going to have to do all of that again? Yep, theater, new scene. I'll leave that on, I think. I don't want to be attacked yet. Thanks. Thanks all the same. So, New York's finest? Is that what we needed? Hello, Ash. Hello, friend. Abby's just dipped out to play a little bit of Minecraft with hubby, but thank you for stopping by. How are you doing today? Let me try Cult of the World. I forget which one we found the echo with. It was this one.
It's you, following your master into Lama.
How was your day? How was your weekend? Tell me everything.
Funny masks and hoods, pretending to be a secret society.
Just got off work? Nice, nice. What do you do? You don't have to tell me exactly. You don't have to tell me at all if you don't want to. But yeah, let's get to know each other a bit more.
Clip of the Lost Film survived. You will see, Mr. Casey.
Okay, so yeah, we played the clip, the missing clip, and we got immediately bum rushed by some
Nightless Night was
some difficult
film.
Types.
They played a role in this story.
So, hopefully, if I stay in the well lit room, we'll be okay. Maybe? I don't know. Master crew trainer McDonald's. Am I weak? Well, it's been but hopefully things look up soon. Nice. Do you know what? We were talking about McDonald's the other day. Absolutely in the mood for some of those fries. Real nice. Real nice. But yeah, sounds like a good job. You've been doing that today? Specifically doing that today? Must be tiring. Do you think that you're a good teacher? Do you think you're a good trainer? Do you think you're good at imparting your knowledge on people? Because I have a real appreciation for people that can do that. I really wanted to do some teaching. I was kind of on track to do something, but yeah, the past 4 years have been a bit weird, obviously. So yeah, plans have changed, but yeah, it takes a lot of courage and self-belief to be training or teaching anybody in any capacity. So yeah, sounds good. But yeah, I bet you're happy to be done. If I go out of here, will I be attacked? Oh God, I think so.
Zane was in the clip holding my lamp. Was he playing me in his film? Zane's lamp on the screen.
Could use some work. I tend to be more friendly than having authority. I think I could work on that and not getting frustrated so easy. I think we sound like quite similar people. I try to kill people with kindness, not necessarily when I'm teaching them, but in all parts of life. But yeah, I think I don't know if I'm good at understanding people. I don't know if I'm very good with humans. So sometimes when I'm certain of something, but that thing turns out to not be true, I can get quite frustrated. So
no light.
Yeah,
I could transfer the light.
But it's difficult. I think there's a balance between being friendly and authoritative. Because if you're like a drill sergeant, everybody will hate you. But if you're everybody's best friend, they won't take you seriously. So yeah, there's always a balance to be struck, I think. If I leave here, will I get killed? That's all I want to know. Yeah. Supposed to be doing. Find a way into the projection booth. Watch the fragments on the film in the theater. Oh, I think I've got to change this, but I think I'm immediately going to get attacked, so. God, it was so difficult to kill. people are difficult to kill. So the projection booth. Where would the...
Alan, wake. Wake. Alan. Wake. Wake.
I think it's something to do with changing the light in here. But I'm worried that I'm going to get attacked. Take too many bullets to die, my friend. Ow. I'm not strong enough. So where would the projection booth be? Let's take a look at the map. So screen, yes. A projection room is upstairs. Okay, right, so we're going to the screen, then we've got to leave again, okay. Plot board. New York's finest, I think, was the one we wanted. And that gives us this. No. Nope, shit. Shit. Oh, fuck. I'm gonna be killed before I can even change it back. Ugh. Locked. Okay. It's safer now. Cult of the Word? Which one gave me the ability to see the echo? Here's the echo.
It's you, following your master into La La
Land. La La Land.
Good day, sir.
Hello, Saffy. Have a good luck, friend. Thanks for stopping by.
Maybe it is you who's playing a role, Mr. Casey. A role carefully laid out for you. The puppet.
Right, let's leave. Wait a minute, did I get given the thing I need? Don't think I did. I think I've got to wait for all of this conversation to play.
Following your master into La La Land. A sad bunch of clowns, funny masks and hoods, pretending to be a secret society. Maybe it is you who's playing a role, Mr. Casey. A role carefully laid out for you. The puppet. Blindly performing the ritual steps for the glory of the cult, huh? What the fuck have you been smoking? Nightless night. A clip of the lost film survived. You will see, Mr. Casey. In the nightless night, you will finally see.
Right, lost clip of the film. So I think what I need to do
is
leave. Oh, crap. It sounds like a lot of people are chasing me at the moment. Can I get up to the projection booth? I'm wondering if this is the projection booth in here. Uh, No. Okay, maybe I've got to watch it through.
Changing a plot element in a
scene. Oh, I can't change the plot elements. Ugh. Okay. God, I've got so many people chasing. Ow! Okay, out of ammo. Run. Run. I don't want to do all of that again for the seventh time. I'm going to save. Get the fuck out of my way, everyone. Not the shoebox. Quick save. Yep. Okay. So what are we doing? Find a way into the projection booth. Watch the fragment. Yep. So we've got to do the fragment. Fuck. I do not have enough bullets for this shit. Ow. Fucking God. Too many people. There are too many of them. And I'm so weak. Alan is so weak. I wish he wasn't. It takes forever to heal as well. I've completely given up trying to heal. I normally get killed mid-heal. Okay, right, let me heal while I'm safe. That'll do. So, I want to go back into the theater. I want to watch the clip. Oh, I'm about to be attacked. Yep. Did I not kill anybody?
The light of the lamp shone out of the screen and revealed the door. Zane's lamp on the screen had no light. I could transfer the light on my lamp to his.
The story is a monster.
Please light the flare. Please, sweet Jesus, just light the flare. Where's the door? They said a door appeared somewhere. Alan, I need you to go quicker. A lot of angry people here, Alan. Where was the door? I don't see any door. Oh, fuck. Door. Alan, don't tease me by telling me there's a door. I can't see any fucking door. Nope. Nope. I feel weirdly weak in this game, I have to be honest. I feel like I've upgraded my health at least once as well. Continue. Find a way into the projection booth, watch the fragments.
Stop
was that? I don't even know where I'm being attacked from anymore. What have I got? Anything else? Nothing. I've got nothing to deal with these people. I've got nothing. The cupboards are empty. No shotgun ammo. I've got a couple of flares. Continue. Can I not have a minute's peace? Seriously. Can I not have 1 minute's peace? Reload. Clip of the lost film.
What is this?
Oh, of course it attacks me just when I'm fucking healing. God damn it. Here's where the door is, right. Thank Christ.
I was back out into the night. The seedy alley away from prying eyes was a good scene for dark deeds.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. There's a save point. Run! Run! I think it was fairly simple to figure out what to do. It's the fact that we are, I mean, it might just be me not picking up, you know, collectibles, not upgrading the right things. But yeah, I feel very weak in this game. So knowing what to do wasn't the problem. It was doing it without being murdered every 2 fucking seconds. All right, what's that? Ah. Right, we got some shotgun ammo. Out Into the Night. Plot board for Out Into the Night. What am I supposed to do out here? Oh. Clip of the lost film? I feel like this is just going to get me attacked by a million people.
In the city trapped in eternal night, they watch the film where the night never arrives, where the night hides in your mind.
Door is locked. I'm curious whether it won't be locked if I change the scene. Oh. Hello. Something's happening.
A police car felt important to the story. I was close to finding the solution.
Investigate the alley. Oh, here we go. Missing half of an echo. To go along with that. Oh, there it is. Yeah, there's somebody down there. They may need my help. They may all. This might be the past, so they might already be dead. But...
Think they're gonna want us to, like, cut off a finger or something? For this initiation, do you?
Nah. I'm sure we'll just chant some ceremonial stuff. Nothing to it.
Well, it's about time. We paid our dues. Made plenty of their problems disappear. Dumped all those nobodies down that chute.
What we did or didn't do, it's all behind us now. We're going straight to the top, partner.
Yep, like we died and went to heaven.
Was that all I was looking for out here? Maybe. Unless I was supposed to take this light into a different scene. I'll go to the rooftop where someone fell. So this door might finally be open now. Still locked. Brilliant. Right, the rooftop where someone fell. How the fuck are we getting up there?
Someone had fallen to their death from the rooftop.
How? Getting up there. Is that where we came down from? Investigate Investigate the rooftop. Let's try moving back to clip of the lost film.
Well.
Come back, Mello. Well. That's a very good TV show, by the way. It's got Matt Berry in it, unsurprisingly. I only watch things with Matt Berry in. That's what we're learning. Oh, shooting zombies. Nice. Abby's just gone off to do some, I was about to say Minesweeper. Minecraft with Hubby. And I am lost as all hell. That is Ray Bloody Purchase from the TV show Toast of London. Minesweeper, yeah. Can you imagine? Maybe it might come into fashion again, you know?
I should look at the plot board. Keep the story moving.
Yeah, I don't think this is the right one. I think the one we wanted was the one with the echo, but at the same time, I don't know how to get up there. Was it New York's finest? The IT crowd. What, Matt Berry from the IT crowd? It's not that one. Cult of the Word. What he was in. Yeah, Matt Berry's in Toast of London, IT crowd, Mighty Boosh, Year of the Rabbit, What We Do in the Shadows, Garth Marenghi's Dark Place. I don't know how we get up there. Maybe I don't need to get up there. Maybe this is just like a perspective puzzle, like in Viewfinder. Where would the rest of it be? Go to the roof and find where someone fell. How the fuck am I getting up to the roof? I can't even go back up here. I think this is where we came from. I'm stuck. I can't go back up there. Let me take a look at the map. Yeah, that goes up here, but that's locked. This we know. Prop storage, we've been in here. What the fuck is that? Flare gun ammo. I did not see you before. What's that echo? Yeah. But where's the other side of the light shift inactive? Maybe that's what I'm missing. Where is the light shift? I think that's where it was referring to where the car was, but the car's not here anymore. Fuck. Yeah, that door's locked in every scene. I don't know how to get up there. I don't know how to get back inside. New York's finest. Okay, that remains the same. What about Cult of the Word? I think we might have already been in Cult of the Word, actually. Yeah, what about Clip? So are we just locked out here now? Is this our life now? It might well be. Is there a ladder I'm missing? Is there a walkway I'm missing? I don't feel like there is. That's the safe spot. That's a vehicle. This is still locked because it's always locked. Why do I need that?
I was making progress.
Was I? Am I, Alan? How am I making progress, Alan? I have no clue. Find a way into the projector. Go to the roof and find where someone fell. Let's see if he says it again. He didn't say it again. I think I might change to a different game. I have no earthly idea what's happening in this game. Most of the time that's the case. But yeah, it's even worse right now. I'm gonna start a new stream within 60 seconds. So if anybody wants to see me play, I'm gonna play some Viewfinder. I need to de-stress. So if anybody wants to see me play Viewfinder, make sure to refresh in about 60 seconds. I'll see you in a minute.